pleased to be with President Moon of South Korea. We have a long-term friendship, and we are making a lot of progress. We are working on tremendous trade deals. And we, as you know, we've completed a trade deal, and that's working out very well for both countries. That deal is completed now, and it's been in existence for, solidly in existence for 6 months, and it's been very good. And we intend to do some additional things on trade. Of course, we'll be talking about North Korea. We'll be talking about the purchase of equipment. South Korea is one of our largest purchases of military equipment, and we're working together very well.
예, 먼저 감사드리고 오늘 한국에서 오신 문재인 대통령을 만나뵙게 되어서 굉장히 기쁘게 생각을 합니다. 우리 두 사람은 굉장히 오랫동안 우회를 유지하고 있는 경험도 있고 우리 양국 간의 관계에 있어서도 상당히 많은 진전이 있었습니다. 양국 간의 교역 협상에 있어서도 저희가 굉장히 많은 부분의 진전을 보았고 지금 완성을 시킨 상태로 6개월 동안 진행이 되고 있는 상태입니다. 그 이외에도 북한에 대해서도 오늘 좀 이야기를 할까 하고요. 그 다음에 한국이 또 저희의 군사 장비를 굉장히 구매하고 계시는 큰 고객이기 때문에 이 부분에 대한 이야기도 나누게 될 것 같습니다.
예, 상견인단의 대통령님을 다시 뵙게 돼서 정말 반갑습니다. 지난번 대통령님의 판문점 방문은 행동으로 평화를 보여주신 아주 세계사적인 장면이었습니다. 대통령님의 상상력과 또 대담한 결정력이 놀랍습니다.
Mr. President, it's a great pleasure to meet you again 3 months after our last meeting. Your visit to Panmunjom will go down as a historic moment that embodied peace through action. And I have to say that I always marvel at your imagination and bold decision-making.
네, 대통령님의 리더십에 의해서 이 남북관계는 크게 발전했고 또 북미 대화가 이어지고 있습니다. 조만간 제3차 북미정상회담을 준비하기 위한 북미 간의 실무협상이 열리리라고 기대를 합니다. 제3차 북미 정상회담이 열린다면 아마도 한반도의 비핵화의 새로운 질서가 만들어지는 아주 세계사적인 대전환 업적이 될 것이라고 믿습니다.
Thanks to your leadership, we have been able to achieve great progress in terms of inter-Korean relations, and this has also led to a dialogue between the United States and North Korea, and soon I will be expecting the working-level negotiations between the United States and North Korea to prepare for the third, your third summit with Chairman Kim to be resumed soon. And when you have your third summit with Chairman Kim, maybe I hope that this will go down as a truly historic moment in world history. This will be a great achievement that equals a great transformation in terms of a complete denuclearization on the Korean Peninsula.
대통령과 함께하는 동안 한미 동맹은 아주 위대한 동맹으로 발전하고 있습니다. 경제적인 면에 있어서도 한미 FTA 개정 협상이 성공적으로 마무리됐고 많은 한국 기업들이 미국에 대한 투자를 늘려나가고 있습니다.
During the time I have been working together with you, the ROC-US alliance has been evolving in a great way. Especially in the economic field, we have been able to revise our bilateral free trade agreements, and that has been a great success, while many Korean companies are increasing their investment in America.
이번 방문 뒤에도 미국의 LNG 가스에 대한 한국의 수입을 추가하는 그런 결정이 이루어지고 또한 한국의 자동차 업계와 미국의 자율운행 기업 간의 합작 투자가 이루어지게 되었는데 이 모두가 한미동맹을 더욱더 든든하게 발전시키는 것이라고 믿습니다.
And during the course of my visit to New York, we'll be signing the deal to increase the import of LNG from America, while we'll also be signing a deal regarding a joint venture between a Korean motor company and an automated vehicle company in America. So I believe that all of this will come to reinforce our already strong alliance.
그 밖에도 한미동맹을 더욱 발전시킬 수 있는 다양한 방안에 대해서 오늘 허심탄회한 그런 대화를 나누기를 기대합니다.
And furthermore, I do look forward to engaging in candid discussions with you today on how we could truly make great progress in our alliance in other aspects as well.
Thank you very much. What's it going to take to have a third summit with Chairman Kim, sir? Well, we'll see. Right now, people would like to see that happen. I want to know what's going to be coming out of it. We can know a lot before the summit takes place. We had really two very successful summits. There's been, as you know, there's been no lessening of the sanctions. There's only been an increasing of the sanctions. But very importantly, we have our hostages back, and that was a very big deal. And we got our hostages back. We have the remains of our great heroes from the past back, a lot of them, and they're coming in. And they actually have a lot of them ready to start coming in again. So a lot of things have happened, plus there's been no nuclear testing at all for the last quite a long period of time, at least that we can detect. And the relationships have been very good. So we'll see what happens. But we'd like to see if we can do something, and if we can, that'll be great. And if we can't, that's fine. We'll see what happens. But there's been no nuclear testing for a long time, a long time.
Mr. President, for guns, do you plan on announcing a gun plan in the coming days? And if so, is it going to include background checks?
Well, we're working very much with the Republicans, and we're working also with the Democrats, but a lot of the Democrats are wasting their time on nonsense, on pure nonsense. So they don't have much time to work on guns, unfortunately. If they did, it would be probably pretty easy to do. But we always have to protect our Second Amendment. It's very important. I saw where this character from Texas, I can't imagine he'll get one vote in Texas. He wants to start confiscating guns. That's not a good thing. That's no good. It makes it actually much harder to make a deal when this Beto O'Rourke comes out and starts talking about confiscating guns. When you do that, it makes it much tougher. But the Democrats are really just wasting so much time on nonsense, on junk. And if they focused on this, they could get it done. But we have to protect our Second Amendment. We have to protect people that want and need guns. And we have to keep guns out of the hands of crazy people and sick people. Very simple. Not very complicated.
Are you considering sanctions, considering actions first before denuclearization as part of your new method for the denuclearization process?
Sanctions where?
Sanctions first before denuclearization as part of your new method in denuclearization talks.
You're going to have to speak up. Say it again. Sanctions. Go ahead.
Sanctions, considering actions first before denuclearization.
Where?
For North Korea in the denuclearization talks.
I'm not considering actions. We're getting along very well with North Korea. I have a good relationship with Kim Jong-un, and we're not considering actions at all. There's no reason for actions. I will say this. If I weren't president, you'd be at war with North Korea, in my opinion. If the same group was in that preceded me, you'd be in a war with North Korea. So we're not looking at any actions. We have a good relationship with Kim Jong-un. We'll see what happens. Maybe we'll be able to make a deal, maybe not.
Mr. President, I meant
the
sanctions first.
Go ahead.
Mr. President, there was breaking news just now.
More breaking news?
More breaking news.
There's always breaking news. It's usually breaking fake news. Go ahead.
Two rockets just landed in the green zone in Baghdad. Do you see this as an escalation in the Middle East?
I don't know anything about it. You just tell me it's breaking news. So I'll have to see it. You know, right now I'm here. I haven't heard it.
But this is not the first
When did this happen?
Just now, but it's not the first time.
No, that's not the first time. Nope. We'll look into it. We're going to look into it.
But are you worried about the U.S. embassy in Baghdad, the security there?
We're going to look into it. I know nothing about it. You just told me it's breaking, so therefore I assume it's relatively new, like within the last 4 days. Yeah, we're going to discuss it. I will be discussing. Yeah, I will be discussing. We didn't have an agreement on short-range missiles, and a lot of people in a lot of countries test short-range missiles. There's nothing spectacular about that, but we will be discussing that also. Okay?
Can we hear from President Moon if he is troubled by the short-range missiles and if he'd like to see you maybe try to stop it from happening?
Take a look at it. We're going to talk about it, but I didn't really discuss that with Kim Jong-un. That was never part of our discussion. We did discuss nuclear testing and other things, and frankly, he's lived up to his word on those things that we discussed. We actually signed an agreement in Singapore, and we actually had two very good meetings. You would have been at war right now with North Korea if I weren't president. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.